Oh yeah, what about this guy? Oh yeah, this guy.
For me, it's not just about individually getting off fossil fuels or cleaning up the air in my own home. It's also about, you know, saving the planet. And so it can't just be us that does this. Everybody has to be able to do it.
Ever wonder what it's like to electrify everything inside your home? Today we're at the house of Justin and Kathryn in beautiful San Francisco Bay, and we're about to find out how they made that happen.
Hi, I'm Justin.
I'm Kathryn, and we're in the San Francisco Bay Area talking about our home electrification project.
I would say I'm the most proud of getting entirely off of gas, because there were moments during the middle of the project where we felt like, you know what, forget the dryer. We just gotta get this thing done. You know, it's okay if one appliance is running on gas. I'm just really glad that we actually did the whole thing, and that we can then turn around and tell other people this is possible. It's actually fairly easy once you know what you're doing. If I could go back and tell people how to do this correctly from the start, I would say solar should be the very last thing you do, because your solar system is sized to all the other stuff you do. And so we just were like, well, we just want solar, we don't care. And so we put solar on, but actually it matters, you know, the size of the system that you need and all of those things. The moment when that we realized that you could, you know, use a heat pump, that it wouldn't be that expensive, and in fact, it would be just as good, if not better, than the gas alternative, that was like a very big piece of the wall coming down between us and, you know, the end game. We obviously love our electric vehicle. That's the one I would say, like when we go and look at the costs, that is the hands down winner of electrification is the car. Because even with a Prius, which is a very efficient vehicle that everybody would recognize as, you know, low miles per gallon and saving you money, we save roughly half with our Bolt. So it's a pretty big deal. It's pretty awesome. We have a little kid. And especially when it comes to burning natural gas in the house, that is actually kind of an overlooked human health problem. And so, you know, it's marginally better than burning cow dung in a hut, but not much actually when you look at the data. And so, you know, with little kids, it just felt like that's crazy. It's just kind of archaic. So the more we can get this stuff out of our lives, the better. I find it weird that people are obsessed with the difference between a gas stove and an electric stove. Like, I mean, I understand there's some bits of a traditional electric resistant stove that might be, you know, might bother some people, but I feel like that's more kind of inertia and people stuck in their ways, and that once you switch, you wouldn't even notice, and maybe you might even like it more, frankly. It's just one of those things that human nature, we like what we have, we don't know what we don't have. So I think the biggest thing for us was the heat pump. So that was the big thing that was kind of a sticking point with a lot of local contractors. You know, you go out and ask five contractors, is it possible to not have a gas heater? And five of them say, absolutely not, you're crazy. So find a trusted local contractor who doesn't just automatically reflexively tell you that's impossible. And if they do tell you it's impossible, they're not the right contractor for you.
Keep looking.
Keep looking, yeah, because they're out there, but you have to actually look pretty hard. I think that for me, a lot of home improvement had been like mysterious, and I didn't understand how houses worked. I didn't understand how electricity worked. I didn't understand how plumbing worked. I didn't understand what was behind my wall. And so, you know, as a new homeowner, you freak out when anything happens, and you don't feel empowered to fix it, and you don't even feel empowered to know if the guy that comes in to tell you it's a $5,000 fix, you don't know if it's really a $5,000 fix or not. And so going through all of this has completely removed that fear and that lack of understanding and knowledge of how homes work. And that's been, I think, pretty empowering for me personally. The biggest challenge we face is collective inaction. So, you know, the feeling of antipathy, the feeling that my own individual actions don't matter, has a self-fulfilling prophecy that ensures we are all screwed. And so as much as it feels like, oh, what is my one little project going to do? I think the reality is that every single action has an impact, and you will, in your actions, cause somebody else to act, and it will have a domino effect that, you know, frankly, we desperately need in these times. And so I just think it's really important that people recognize that it matters if you do these things, no matter how small they may feel.
Sustainability is a huge part of our lives, from the work we both do to, you know, how we try to live. Having a sustainable home has been really one of the most exciting, you know, pieces of that. You know, there were times when, you know, in the middle of this project, it was so frustrating that we we just wanted to throw our hands up. And I think that being able to see it all the way through is something that makes us really proud.
For me, there was a big disconnect between, you know, the things I think need to happen in the world and then maybe what we are actually ourselves doing. And so there's something extremely powerful in aligning your words and deeds, but it's 100% doable. And I personally feel when you're done, you look back and the way, you know, you look at your life and you just feel so much happier and more proud, you know, because you're literally running on sunshine at some level. It's pretty cool. You know, we really firmly believe that this is actually a fairly simple thing to do, and we couldn't be more excited about the end result. I know that everything, to the extent that we can control it in our lives, is as sustainable as we can make it, and that's, you know, you couldn't ask for much more than that.
Oh, you mashed him up. Oh, man.